Demolition charges. The Geth must have planted them.
And
hurry,
welcome back.
We need to find them all and shut them down.
So let's play Mass Effect Blind. I know some people are going to be disappointed. But I am going... Gameplay. I'm going to casual difficulty. Sorry, guys. It's just, I don't want to die over and over again. And... I don't know, maybe some of you like seeing me die over and over again. I get frustrated with someone die over and over again myself. See how easy that is? I'm not sure if that's an indicator, but looks like it's been made easier. I'd rather just experience the game and not have to worry about dying constantly. Okay, so I got two. Can't even see him from there. Bring it on, we're on casual, baby. Can I even work through that? Now we're ready. Got two charges left. One of them's... Can we... Get out of this? Thank you. Third charge. One's down at the end somewhere. Okay, there they are. What is this? Oh. The other charge is somewhere around here. Yeah. Plenty of time left. So I know there's more equipment. Ooh, armor plating. I think that's because we switched to casual. We have armor plating. I think. Yeah. Hardened ceramic plates can be applied to body armor suits, increasing their effectiveness. Well, it's only plus 5. First aid interface. Plus 1 health regeneration per second. Can I use both? Just make it super easy for me. I just want it a little easier. Just for the record, just a little easier. Tech biotic protection. What's the trade-off here? What's better? I don't even know. One has better damage protection, the other one has better tech biotic protection. I have grenades. Oh. I didn't realize I had grenades. G for grenade. And I set that up. Reaper. I can't even use a sniper rifle. Hurricane. Oh, we have Hurricane. D6. What do you think? Doesn't do as much damage. I don't know. So I have what? Grenade go. Sheesh. Okay, that's how long it takes to explode. I should have waited longer to move forward. Now, I know we're on casual, but we would still die. Oh, good. Oh, here's the beacon. So coming up here... Yeah, aside from gathering all this crap, this is as far as I've played.
I'll stay right here.
In fact, I don't even know if I went into this. And he'll stay right there. Hope you guys aren't too disappointed. Well, this is moving weird, isn't it? I'm taking too long. Nah. Do we get unlimited tries? Maybe on casual we do. Oh, man. Hammer and Reaper. Sniper rifles, yeah. What's she using? She's using Avenger. She's also using Avenger. I don't know. I'll omni-gel it. Okay, so he's using Storm. Hurricane. Scimitar. The accuracy isn't that worse, and yeah. Use Hurricane, and I'll get rid of these storms. Ashley is using Storm. Alright, so. Assault Rifle Banshee. Yeah. Lancer. Okay. I think I'm getting the hang of some of the crap here. A little bit. How about not putting a gun in her?
We thought this world was safe until the Geth showed up.
See if there's any goodies. Combat sensor. Oh, an ammo upgrade. Okay, take all. Nice. Oh, it looked like we were in first person mode for a second there. I was like, woo! Oh well. Can't change that. Alright, this is me. Some enemies use jamming technology to block your weapon radar. The combat scanner upgrade improves detection levels, making these enemies visible. Sounds good to me. Anti-personnel rounds. Okay. What are the, what's this? Armor piercing rounds. Well, as long as we're not fighting Geth. I wonder if it would use on those things that the Geth bring back. Or are those also Geth? We sound like we're very heavy, don't we? Anything else? It's up here. Nothing. Nothing. I want to see all there is to see, because I think... Oh, this is where it came from. Duh. I have a feeling about this thing. See what's over on this side. Any more lockers and stuff like that? Nope, I don't see anything. Can't do anything with those, huh? Oh, there's a locker here. See that? A Reaper one and Guardian armor. Sniper rifle. Yeah, we've been deciding not to use the Reaper, so I'm gonna omni-gel that. Guardian armor. Can't use it yet, I guess. Nope. We can give Ashley Guardian armor. Oh wait, can we? Huh. improvement. Yeah, the shields are like just a little bit down. Damage protection's better. I might want it whenever I level up and can use it. Alright, guys.
My god. It's like someone dropped a bomb.
Oh, okay.
That must be where the Geth ship landed.
It cuts in when I walk away from it. Okay, so... Right. So the rest is completely blind, guys. I know it's been quite a few episodes. But, it took me so long to just, you know... I think when I tried this game out the first time, I was playing it on normal also, and I really couldn't get very far. I don't know what it is. Do better with Crysis than games like this, I think, because it's first-person shooter and squad, and it's got so much, and I don't understand the squad commands. What I want to do with the squad is like directly tell them, take cover here. You know, I don't know if there's a way to do that, you know. It's all in real time, so it'd be really frantic to do so anyway. Here we go. Blind territory.
Normandy, the beacon is secure.
This is amazing. Actual working Prothean technology. Unbelievable.
Williams in a new
anything
armor.
Like that when they dug it up.
Something must have activated it.
Roger, Normandy. Standing by.
Huh? It's got Kanan. Ooh.
Shep!
It's got me.
Don't touch her. It's too dangerous.
Ooh. What were we seeing there? Was that a flashback of ours, or we were seeing something new? Information. And that, blasted itself, trying to... whatever the hell it did. Oh, here come the shadows. Call the Vorlons!
We identified the ship that touched down on Eden Prime.
Boobs.
The Normandy. A human alliance vessel.
Mm.
It was under the command of Captain Anderson. They managed to save the colony.
And the beacon.
One of the humans may have used it.
That must be the one that Marina Sirtis is playing. I heard she did a voice in this game. Well, she never showed that much cleavage on Star Trek Next Generation. Counselor Deanna Troi, if anyone was wondering.
Chakwas. I think she's waking up.
Man, what a hangover.
You had us worried there, Shepard. How are you feeling?
Someone get the license number of that truck?
Like the morning after shore leave. How long was I out?
About 15 hours. Something happened down there with the beacon, I think.
Yeah, something.
It's my fault. I must have triggered some kind of security field when I approached it. You had to push me out of the way.
Don't blame yourself.
You had no way to know what would happen.
Actually,
smile.
We don't even know if that's what set it off. Unfortunately, we'll never get the chance to find out.
The beacon exploded. A system overload, maybe. And the blast knocked you cold. Williams and I had to carry you back here to the ship.
Was I hurt? Or just unconscious?
What's the damage, Doctor?
Physically, you're fine. but I detected some unusual brain activity. Abnormal beta waves.
What's that noise?
I also noticed an increase in your rapid eye movement. Signs typically associated with intense dreaming.
Not a dream. A vision.
I saw... I'm not sure what I saw. Death, destruction... Nothing's really clear.
I better add this to my report. It may... Oh. Captain Anderson.
Hey.
How's our exo holding up, Doctor?
Well, all the readings look normal. I'd say the commander's going to be fine.
Glad to hear it. Shepard, I need to speak with you. In private.
It's easy for her to say.
Aye, aye, Captain. I'll be in the mess if you need me.
Sounds like that beacon hit you pretty hard, Commander. Are you sure you're okay?
Yeah, what happened to Williams?
Did we leave Gunnery Chief Williams back on Eden Prime?
I figured we could use a soldier like her. She's been reassigned to the Normandy.
Good.
Williams is a good soldier. She deserves it.
Lieutenant Elenko agrees with you. That's why I added her to our crew.
Jenkins. Yeah, I feel bad about Jenkins. I forgot who he was for a second.
I don't like soldiers dying under my command.
Jenkins wasn't your fault. You did a good job, Shepard.
Pretty pissed off about the gas.
Intel dropped the ball, sir. We had no idea what we were walking into down there. That's why things went to hell.
The Geth haven't been outside the Vale in 2 centuries, Commander. Nobody could have predicted this.
Yeah, well, you wanted to talk?
You said you needed to see me in private, Captain.
I won't lie to you, Shepard. Things look bad. Nihlus is dead. The beacon was destroyed and Geth are invading.
Joker will be happy.
The Council's going to want answers.
I did my job.
The Geth would have wiped out the whole colony if I hadn't stopped them.
I'll stand behind you and your report, Shepard. You're a damned hero in my books. That's not why I'm here. It's Saren, that other Turian. Saren's a specter, one of the best, a living legend. But if he's working with the Geth, it means he's gone rogue. A rogue specter's trouble. Saren's dangerous. And he hates humans.
He hates humans?
Why?
He thinks we're growing too fast, taking over the galaxy. A lot of aliens think that way. Most of them don't do anything about it. But Saren has allied himself with the Geth. I don't know how. I don't know why. I only know it had something to do with that beacon. You were there just before that beacon self-destructed. Did you see anything? Any clue that might tell us what Saren was after?
Yeah, I saw a vision. Why the hell would he side with the Geth anyway? They're like freaking android murderous things.
Just before I lost consciousness, I had some kind of vision.
A vision? A vision of what?
Couldn't even tell. Am I guessing what it really is? Are we deciding what the vision is with our answer here? Seen something like that recently with a scene in Pillars of Eternity. You're determining the past of what your character was doing in her past life. What is the vision? It's a warning, it's a war, it's death. I think it was a warning.
I saw synthetics. Geth, maybe. Slaughtering people. Butchering them.
I didn't see that.
We need to report this to the Council, Shepard.
I'm gonna have to go back over this, over that scene. And, hit frame by frame. See what I can see. Kind of cheating, I know, but... We need to report this to the Council. What will we say?
What are we gonna tell them? I had a bad dream?
We don't know what information was stored in that beacon. Lost Prothean technology? Blueprints for some ancient weapon of mass destruction? Whatever it was. Saren took it. But I know Saren. I know his reputation, his politics. He believes humans are a blight on the galaxy. This attack was an act of war. He has the secrets from the beacon. He has an army of Geth at his command, and he won't stop until he's wiped humanity from the face of the galaxy.
Not if I can help it.
I'll find some way to take him down.
It's not that easy. He's a specter. He can go anywhere, do almost anything. That's why we need the Council on our side.
So we expose him.
We prove Saren's gone rogue and the Council will revoke his Spectre status.
Well, that accomplished that.
And see if he can get us an audience with the Council. He'll want to see us as soon as we reach the Citadel. We should be getting close. Head up to the bridge and tell Joker to bring us into dock.
Huh. Well, what good is that gonna do? We're gonna revoke his Spectre status. He can still do whatever the hell he wants with commanding the Geth all over the place. Ooh, replenish the medigel. Plus 4. Oh, cool. We can just walk around the ship now. Awesome. You know what? I want to see what's going on with the Codex, though. Hope you guys don't mind. Oh, there's a bunch of crap.
Roughly 1,200 years ago, the Turians were invited to join the Citadel Council to fulfill the role of galactic peacekeepers. The Turians have the largest fleet in Citadel space, and they make up the single largest portion of the Council's military forces. As their territory and influence has spread, the Turians have come to rely on the Salarians for military intelligence and the Asari for diplomacy. Despite a somewhat colonial attitude towards the rest of the galaxy, the ruling hierarchy understands they would lose more than they would gain if the other two races were ever removed. Turians come from an autocratic society that values discipline and possesses a strong sense of personal and collective honor. There is lingering animosity between Turians and humans over the First Contact War of 2157, which is known as the Relay 314 incident to the Turians. Officially, however, the two species are allies, and they enjoy civil, if cool, diplomatic relations.
There's a lot of, there's a lot of things in common with the, humans and Turians here, as, the humans and the Minbari on Babylon 5. Same deal. I mean, I don't know if it was due to a misunderstanding. I don't know why the war broke out specifically, if they're going to tell us that. But yeah. The whole thing, they're now allies, but there's still a lot of bad feelings behind it all. You can't just get rid of that. They you know, the people died.
50,000 years ago, the Protheans were the only spacefaring species in the galaxy. They vanished in a swift galactic extinction.
Wow.
Only the legacy of their empire remains. They are believed to have built the mass relays and the Citadel, which have allowed numerous species to explore and expand throughout the galaxy.
So we just found the stuff.
Protean ruins are found on worlds across the galaxy. While surprisingly intact for their age, functioning examples of Prothean paleotechnology are rare. Time and generations of looters have picked their dead cities and derelict stations clean. Some believe the Protheans meddled in the evolution of younger races. The Hanar homeworld of Kaje, for example, shows clear evidence of former Prothean occupation.
Kaje.
The presence of a former Prothean observation post on Mars has caused a rebirth of interventionary evolutionists among humans. These individuals believe the god myths of ancient civilizations are misremembered encounters with aliens.
Yeah. There's a lot of people today who believe that. So, yeah. This is found technology. As far as I can tell, nobody developed this technology. They just found it and found out how to use it. Non-council races. The League of Non-Aligned Worlds?
The Geth are a humanoid race of networked AIs.
No, not
they were
that
created
much.
By the Quarians 300 years ago as tools of labor and war. When the Geth showed signs of self-evolution, the Quarians attempted to exterminate them. The Geth won the resulting war. This example has led to legal, systematic repression of artificial intelligences in galactic society. The Geth possess a unique distributed intelligence. An individual has rudimentary animal instincts, but as their numbers and proximity increase, the apparent intelligence of each individual improves.
Huh.
In groups, they can reason, analyze situations, and use tactics, as well as any organic race.
That's pretty interesting.
Geth space is located at the trailing end of the Perseus Arm, beyond the lawless Terminus systems. The Perseus Veil, an obscuring dark nebula of opaque gas and dust, lies between their space and the Terminus systems.
Huh. So that puts a new spin on, what's happened in certain countries on Earth, where certain people aren't allowed to group together in, like, more than two or three or something like that. They group together and they become stronger and more intelligent. Well, stronger in intelligence and reasoning. Non-sapient creatures?
After the Geth secure
a
location, they round up and impale dead and living bodies on mechanical spikes. The spikes rapidly transform these victims into withered husks, extracting water and trace minerals, and replacing them with cybernetics. The cybernetics reanimate the lifeless flesh and tissue, transforming the bodies into mindless killing machines. Some Alliance soldiers refer to the husk-generating spikes as dragon's teeth, a reference to the mythological berserkers who sprang up from the earth wherever the teeth of the dragon Eris were planted. Dragon's teeth and husks bear little resemblance to other pieces of Geth technology. No one is sure why a synthetic race would bother to drain the minuscule amount of recoverable resources from organic corpses, though the value of reusing them as shock troops is obvious.
Huh. So it's like they're close, like a cross between a zombie and a Borg.
The Citadel is an ancient deep space station, presumably constructed by the Protheans. Since the Prothean extinction, numerous species have come to call the Citadel home. It serves as the political, cultural, and financial capital of the galactic community. To represent their interests, most species maintain embassies on the Presidium, the Citadel's inner ring. The Citadel Tower, in the center of the Presidium, holds the Citadel Council chambers. Council affairs often have far-reaching effects on the rest of the galactic community. Five arms, known as the Wards, extend from the Presidium. Their inner surfaces have been built into cities, populated by millions of inhabitants from across the galaxy. The Citadel is virtually indestructible. If attacked, the station can close its arms to form a solid, impregnable shell. For as long as the station has existed, an enigmatic race called the Keepers has maintained it.
Oh, cool.
Spectres are agents from the Office of Special Tactics and Reconnaissance, and answer only to the Citadel Council. They are elite military operatives, granted the authority to deal with threats to peace and stability in whatever way they deem necessary. They operate independently or in groups of two or three. Some are empathetic peacekeepers, resolving disputes through diplomacy. Others are cold-blooded assassins, ruthlessly dispatching problem individuals. All get the job done one way or another, often operating outside the bounds of galactic law. The Spectres were founded after the Salarians joined the Council. For many years, they operated in secrecy, as backroom problem solvers. Only after the Krogan rebellions did their activities become publicized. Assignment of a Spectre is less contentious than a military deployment, but makes it clear that the Council is concerned about a situation. Humanity's first contact with an alien race occurred in 2157. At that time, the Alliance allowed survey fleets to activate any dormant mass relays discovered. a practice considered dangerous and irresponsible by Council-aligned races. When a Turian patrol discovered a human fleet attempting to activate a relay, they attacked. One human vessel survived, retreating to the colony of Shanxi. The Turians followed, quickly defeating the local forces. Shanxi was occupied, the first and to date only human world to be conquered by an alien species. The Turians believed the handful of ships they defeated represented the bulk of human defenses, so they were unprepared when the Second Fleet, under Admiral Castany Drescher, launched a strong counteroffensive, evicting them from Shanxi. The Turians mobilized for full-scale war, drawing the attention of the rest of the galaxy. The Council quickly intervened, forcing a truce. Fortunately for humanity, the First Contact War was ended with a diplomatic solution.
Yeah, right. I wonder if we would have been wiped out otherwise.
The Systems Alliance is an independent supranational government representing the interests of humanity as a whole. The Alliance is responsible for the governance and defense of all extrasolar colonies and stations. The Alliance grew out of the various national space programs as a matter of practicality. Sol's planets had been explored and exploited through piecemeal national efforts. The expense of colonizing entire new solar systems could not be met by any one country. With humans knowing that alien contact was inevitable, there was enough political will to jointly fund an international effort. Still, the Alliance was often disregarded by those on Earth until the First Contact War. While the national governments dithered and bickered over who should lead the effort to liberate Shanxi, the Alliance fleet struck decisively. Post-war public approval gave the Alliance the credibility to establish its own parliament and become the galactic face of humanity. Roughly 50,000... The Geth are a humanoid. After the Geth secure, the Citadel is an ancient humanity's first con. The Terminus systems are located on the far side of the Attican Traverse, beyond the space administered by the Citadel Council or claimed by the Human Systems Alliance. It is populated by a loose affiliation of minor species. United only in their refusal to acknowledge the political authority of the Council or adhere to the Citadel Conventions. Mm. Their independence comes at a price. The Terminus is fraught with conflict. War among the various species is common, as governments and dictators constantly rise and fall. The region is a haven for illegal activities, particularly piracy and the slave trade. At least once a year, a fleet from the Terminus invades the nearby Attican Traverse. These attacks are typically small raids against poorly defended colonies. The Council rarely retaliates, as sending patrols into the Terminus systems could unify the disparate species against their common foe, triggering a long and costly war.
Pretty interesting.
Combat hard suits use a dual-layer system to protect the wearer. The inner layer consists of fabric armor with kinetic padding. Areas that don't need to be flexible, such as the chest or shins, are reinforced with sheets of lightweight ablative ceramic. The outer layer consists of automatically generated kinetic barriers. Objects traveling above a certain speed will trigger the barrier's reflex system and be deflected, provided there is enough energy left in the shield's power cell. Armored hard suits are sealable to protect the wearer from extremes of temperature and atmosphere. Standard equipment includes an onboard mini-frame and a communications, navigation, and sensing suite. The mini-frame is designed to accept and display data from a weapon's smart targeting system to make it easier to locate and eliminate enemies. Kinetic barriers, more commonly called shields, provide protection against most mass accelerator weapons. Whether on a starship or a soldier's suit of armor, the basic principle remains the same. Kinetic barriers are repulsive mass effect fields projected from tiny emitters. These shields safely deflect small objects traveling at rapid velocities. This affords protection from bullets and other dangerous projectiles, but still allows the user to sit down without knocking away their chair. The shielding afforded by kinetic barriers does not protect against extremes of temperature, toxins, or radiation.
I'm not sure what this secondary thing is. I don't want to click that yet. Metagel.
Medigel is a common medicinal salve used by paramedics, EMTs, and military personnel. It combines several useful applications: a local anesthetic, disinfectant, and clotting agent all in one. Once applied, the gel is designed to grip tight to flesh until subjected to a frequency of ultrasound. It is sealable against liquids, most notably blood, as well as contaminants and gases. The
That's gel
is
awesome.
A genetically engineered bioplasm created by the Serta Foundation, a medical technology megacorp based on Earth. Technically, Medigel violates council laws against genetic engineering, but to date, it has proved far too useful to ban.
Genetic engineering was used to come up with this Medigel? It's not technically a living thing, is it? I don't know what primary secondary is. I guess we don't have that yet. Okay, so now we ran over time watching all that. We're listening to all that. Thanks for watching. See you next time when we explore the station. Or at least the quarters there. Ooh, really? Oh, it's vehicles. Oh, okay. Transitions. Oh, to deck one. Deck three. Set destination. We're in medical. Well, I think we're supposed to head to captain's, right? The beacon on Eden Prime was destroyed. Before it self-destructed, it burned horrific images of death and galactic destruction into your mind. Whether these are images of the past or warnings of the future, you really can't say. Right. Oh, okay. This is all the stuff. This is all check. We're supposed to speak with Joker, right, to bring Normandy and Docket at the Citadel. Citadel Station. That's one of the DLCs. I don't have that installed at this time, though. Alright, thanks for watching, guys. See you next time. I'm really enjoying this. Pretty freaking awesome. Thanks for watching. And, yeah, endure. And enduring, grow strong.